Today I will talk about a patient of rectal cancer and also a few lessons we can learn from her history as well as treatment. Mrs. Jinan Khudair presented to us in March of this year. She was having rectal bleeding for more than 2 years but was being treated for inflammatory bowel disease and no further investigations were done. She did not improve and finally underwent a colonoscopy in her home country, Iraq, which showed a rectal ulcer and a large growth. She came to India for further investigations and found to have locally advanced rectal cancer. Since it was locally advanced in form of involvement of multiple nodes and a large growth in the rectum, we gave her chemo and radiation first and followed by surgery. This surgery, we could save her normal passage by using modern techniques like use of staplers, but we had to make a temporary stoma here for passage of stool, which will be closed after a few months. This needed to be done because that area was radiated, and if we just join it back, it won't heal very well and we needed to divert the stool. Now, coming to the lessons that we can learn, this lady had a rectal bleed for more than 2 years but was treated for something else rather than being investigated further and ruling out or diagnosing a cancer at a much earlier stage. Had that happened, she would have probably required only surgery, avoided chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and as a result also avoided the temporary stoma that we have given. The other lesson is, in cases where the rectal cancer becomes locally advanced, that patient will need not only surgery but also chemo as well as radiation. It is better to give chemo and radiation before surgery because once the radiation is given, we can have a better response of the tumor and we can save sphincters in larger number of patients. Also, if radiation and chemotherapy are given after surgery is done, the tolerance of the patient is also poor and the reaction to radiation is higher because the area which we empty, the area from which we remove the intestine, is occupied by other normal intestine and they get radiated. Fortunately, she has undergone all the treatment and tolerated it very well and currently is recovering from surgery.
زوجتي المريضة جنان الله يرحمها عباس زوجتي كانت تشكو من استنساخ مزمن لأكثر من سنتين ونصف ومع خروج بعض الدم من المخرج راجعت أحد الطبيبات في العراق أعطتها علاجات ملينة يعني ما استفادت من العلاج بعد سنتين قررنا انه نعمل لها نابور في العراق فعملوا لها بين انه عندها سرطان بالمستقيم عندما عرفنا النتيجه قررنا انه نجي للهند سالنا احد الاصدقاء نصحنا مستشفى مانيبال لانهم كانوا عاملين عمليه ايضا سرطان القولون لاحد لزوجها زوجة يعني زوجة الصديق زوج جينا المستشفى مانيبال عملوا لنا فحوصات دقيقة ومرينا أول بداية على دكتور كيوش باجباي أعطانا عملنا لنا فحوصات كاملة بعدها قرر أنه نعمل علاج إشعاعي إشعاع ذري مع علاج كيميائي بعد انتهاء هذا العلاج حولونا على دكتور فيدان كابرا اللي قرر لها العملية الجراحية وعملت العملية الحمد لله يعني العملية كانت جيدة ونتائجها يعني مبشرة بخير وبعد عندنا علاج كيميائي بالمستقبل